call a lie a lie.
Okay, so again, so we'll just leave that issue there because no one really believes, with any credibility at least, that there's any widespread voter fraud in this country. Okay, that said, let's move on to something else that's breaking. The New York City Mayor Bill de Blasio will announce later this morning that he is going to request $35 million to cover costs from Election Day to the inauguration because he says Donald Trump is costing his city so much money. Is that a normal amount of money to request, Rebecca?
Well, obviously, Carol, the security concerns and logistics in a city like New York are very different than if this was somewhere else. And because Donald Trump lives in a building that is also used and open to the public, where other people live, where there are other businesses, it becomes exponentially more complicated for the Secret Service to really create a secure environment for the president-elect. Now, I think it would be difficult for even Donald Trump's critics to argue that he doesn't have the right to continue to reside or keep up a residence in Trump Tower because he's lived there, you know, for many, many years. It's a big part of his life. And to expect that the president-elect would just move to a completely different location during this transition period, I think would be a very difficult argument to make. But the issue of Melania Trump potentially staying in New York, staying in that residence after Donald Trump moves into the White House, that will certainly create an opportunity for some of Donald Trump's critics just from a cost and logistics perspective of continuing to protect her, protect Barron Trump, their young son, and the rest of the family in that environment.
So Karen, how long do you think that Melania Trump will stay inside the Trump Tower? Just until the end of the school year? Because nobody really knows.
Nobody does know, but certainly other first families have also wrestled with this question. First families with small children, do you yank them out in the middle of the school year? I think that what we ought to do is give first families some space to make decisions around their children for what they think is the best for their children, because really these kids do not ask for this life that they are being brought into. So I do think that this is an area where we really ought to sort of trust Melania Trump's judgment about what is best for her own child.
Absolutely. Okay, so Bakari.